need to call out there on LA and Bundoran, but we can guarantee one thing, if we do have to, we'll be safe. And I want to thank them very much again for their dedicated work. I just want to wish a speedy recovery to Dennis McManus, his wife Dennis, who was one of the founder members of the RNLA here, and she has been very seriously ill there throughout the Christmas, and on behalf of myself and the councillors here, we wish her a speedy recovery and hope that she can be back here. That's Mrs. McManus, the wife of Dennis McManus. In conclusion, we had a tragedy in Belfast there, and I couldn't let it go. I want to wish on your behalf the sympathy of all the members of Bundoran to little Ciara Agnew, who is from Lisburn but has a summer house here in Tullahan, and her and her sisters are frequent visitors here in Bundoran, and you might have seen it on the TV or read in the paper. She's a 14-year-old girl, and she was coming home from school the other evening, and she died of a heart attack, and at 14, that's very sad. And we send her condolences here from all the members of all the organisations that's in the town here. And I would ask you for 1 minute silence in memory of a 14-year-old who died of a heart attack on the bus on Anderson's Town Road. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and I hope you have a pleasant evening, the rest of the evening, and once again, all the best to the RLLA for the year coming up. Tony McGowan.
I think everybody has spoken, they know all the relevant points up to this. I'd just like to thank Pat and Westend Development for inviting us here. We also express a great deal of gratitude to probably the man that was the head of Bundoran Lifeboat before me, Frank O'Kelly, who started all this. And it's also wonderful to see all the different organisations here in Bundoran, all represented here today, all pulling together, all in the interests of Bundoran and in the interest of saving lives, no matter what, from one organisation. That's all I have to say, and thank you for inviting us.
Now we'll call on Valentine to unplan on Raph.
Just say a few words, Mr. Chairman, first. Chairman of the Westend Development, ladies and gentlemen, a reverend gentleman. This is a day of celebration. I want to thank first the Westend Development, first of all, for erecting the stone and then organising today. It had nothing to do with the weather, the blustery weather, but I suppose the vote was about weather and all weathers and being able to respond in all weathers. I think today is a day of celebration. I know we're not sad today, because what today I think is celebrating is, first of all, I suppose, vision and foresight that arose out of a tragedy in our own community of the need of the vote. It was also a celebration, I think, of safety standards and the contribution of people who understood safety in those days, the contribution of the Waterford RNLI made in the early days, and much, much later the RNLI in our own town. Because the safety standards have kept the crew safe all those years, and you know, we're very lucky that we're not here because somebody got lost at sea. We're not here because of that, and please God that may continue. It also, I think, is a celebration of the generosity of the people of the whole area, because there would never have been a vote without the generosity of the people of Bundoran and the surrounding area. So on a personal note, Mr. Chairman and the Westend Development, I just want to thank you very personally for asking me to unveil the plaque, so I'll do that now. Thank you.
Reverend Noel Regan bless the stone.
What a wonderful work, the RNLI do in saving lives and whenever they're called upon to assist and to help. And particularly on a blustery evening like this, it reminds us of what it is like. And this is picked up actually in St. Mark. In St. Mark's Gospel we read, "With the coming of evening that same day, Jesus said to his disciples, 'Let us cross over to the other side.' And leaving the crowd behind, they took him just as he was in the boat. And there were other boats with him. Then it began to blow a great gale, and the waves were breaking into the boat so that it was almost swamped. But he was in the stern. His head was on the cushion, asleep. They woke him and said to him, 'Master, do you not care? We are lost.' And he woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, 'Be quiet, be calm.' And the wind dropped, and there followed a great calm. And he said to them, 'Why are you so frightened? Have you still no faith?' They were overcome with awe and said to one another, 'Who can this be? Even the wind and the sea obey him.' This is the word of the Lord."
And the response was quite suitable for the occasion. They cried to the Lord and he rescued them. They cried to the Lord and he rescued them. Some sailed to the sea in ships to trade on the mighty waters. These men have seen the Lord's deeds, the wonders he does in the deep. They cried to the Lord and he rescued them. For he spoke. He summoned the gale, tossing the waves of the sea. Then they cried to the Lord on their need, and he rescued them in their distress. They cried to the Lord, and he rescued them. He stilled the storm to a whisper. All the waves of the sea were hushed. They rejoiced because of the calm. He led them to the heaven they desired. They cried to the Lord, and he rescued them. Let them thank the Lord for his love, for the wonders he does for his people. Let them exalt him in the gathering of the people and praise him in the meeting of the elders. He cried to the Lord and he rescued them. Let us pray. Lord God, ruler of the universe, bless this monument and those in whose memory it has been erected. Reward those who have labored in its building. Protect all seafarers in their duties and the dangers of their calling. Bless all who work and make safe the seaways, and all who work in the rescue services. Let the blessing of your peace be upon us all. In the merits of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Just before we finish off now, Pat Nugent will lay a read on behalf of the Westend Development Association, and I would like to acknowledge the presence of a lot of people who use the boat key here, and a lot of people that don't. We have Patrick Doherty here, chairman of the fishermen's group here. We have who uses it pretty often. We have Harry there, who is the master of the key there, and now we have the helicopter coming in there. So they're going to do it this way. I'd also like to acknowledge the presence of Jerry Breslin, the chairman of Bundoran GA Club, and also Terry Brady, who worked very hard to get his money here for the stone, vice chairman of the Bundoran Town Council. PJ Clancy, the fire chief there, and Dick Dobson, the PRO as well, for the RNLI. At this stage, Pat will lay the read on behalf of the West End Development.
As I said, helicopters are there and they're going to give a display. The station is the boat station is open, and anybody that hasn't been down there, I think there's a guided tour down there. You want to go down and mingle around there. And then there's tea and sandwiches in the Allingham. And I would like to thank Peter and Elizabeth McIntyre for the tea and sandwiches down there. That's in the Allingham Hotel. Once again, Pat, just before we finish up, we hope you have a very good season here in Bundoran, and that it's accident-free on the ocean. Once again, Slán agus beannacht agus libh go léir. Thank you very much.
you've been through.
Where's the book?
just put in the salaries now. I don't have something in the salaries. This is
all.
Thank you.